As part of Google's ongoing commitment to a privacy-centric digital advertising ecosystem, we are strengthening the enforcement of our EU user consent policy in March 2024. In this video, we'll cover how to communicate consent signals to preserve customer match audience functionality for your web and app campaigns running in the European Economic Area, or EEA. If you are using customer match lists of users in the EEA, it is essential to complete specific steps as soon as possible. This video tutorial will only cover customer match lists, but will not speak about tag-based remarketing. Consented customer match lists are an important part of an efficient Google Ads strategy. By creating audience lists based on your existing customers, you can re-engage with them across platforms and help AI understand how to identify new customers. Thanks to audience-powered features like value-based bidding and new customer acquisition or app campaigns, and many more. Starting March 2024, we are bolstering enforcement of our existing EU user consent policy. Advertisers using customer match for EEA users must pass consent signals back to Google to communicate users' consent to process data for ad personalization. The action you need to take to ensure you comply with our EU user consent policy depends on the method you use to import user data to Google. Let's review the different options available for uploading customer match and start with the upload of offline data. If you upload customer match lists directly from Google Ads UI, you will need to ensure the file you upload contains first-party data from consented EEA users only. The consent signal will be passed at file upload level, meaning it will apply to all the EEA users included in the file. While accepting customer match terms of service, you must check the box to affirm that the uploaded file only includes 1P data from consented EEA users. If you upload data directly through an API without using a data provider, you'll need to upgrade to the latest version of the API, Google Ads API version 15. This API has been updated with two new consent parameters. Add_user_data controls whether user data can be sent to Google for advertising purposes, and add_personalization whether personalized advertising like remarketing can be enabled, both of which must be granted for using customer match in EEA. If you upload first-party data for store sales reporting and use this data for customer match, you will also need to pass data with consent values for add_user_data and add_personalization. Here you can pass consent values at row level. For additional details, refer to our developer site. If you upload data with a customer match external partner, the same EU user consent policy requirements apply. Work with your data partner to upload 1P data from consented EEA users. Finally, let's look at customer match lists created through conversion-based customer lists. In this scenario, because this data is imported online, the steps are similar to the steps required to maintain tag-based remarketing. 1. Ensure consent banners meet EU user consent policy requirements. 2. Adopt the upgraded consent mode, version 2, to adjust tag behavior based on users' consent status, and pass it back to Google. We recommend working with one of Google-certified consent management platforms, CMP partners, who can help implement a compliant banner, consent mode, and tag settings to collect and communicate consent. For more information on passing consent for online data, watch our video titled "Maintain Tag-Based Remarketing by Capturing Consent." By taking these steps, your customer match audiences will be able to continue powering your campaigns across platforms. This will set you up for success.